Hello friends, today we are going to see a brief introduction about mainframe. What is mainframe? Mainframe, more people think mainframe as the programming language COBOL that is used inside the mainframe or the databases like IMS or DB2. But what is actually a mainframe? Mainframe is like a super box as we see in the image over here. It is like a size of a refrigerator. And that is being the sizes have been reduced these days because of the advancement of the memory technologies. And the key features of the mainframe are these highly processing, it is having high processing power, and it can produce consistent results with the reliability as the main feature, and it can almost have zero downtime, and it is highly securable. And the main feature of mainframe is basically it is a centralized computing system where it can accommodate n number of users at the same time. Talking about the usage of the mainframe in today's world, still mainframe is being used by large number of applications in the world, mainly in the banking, finance, healthcare, retail, manufacturing and much more application side. The operating system like we use in our laptop, the operating system we use Windows or Linux, other operating systems like for mainframe computers we use ZOS, which is the recent operating system, and Unix and Linux can also be used as the operating system on the mainframes. And talking about what are the key mainframe modules that we cover in our training program, the programming language is COBOL, Common Business Oriented Language. It is a simple English-like language. From developer, one can learn the COBOL language and then they can code. Once the program is coded, can be compiled and executed on the mainframe. The job control language, shortly called JCL, is used for executing batch jobs. Now say if you want to print bank statement, n number of bank statement requests can be put together and they can be run as a batch in the nightly or any time. So to run those batch jobs, we need these JCL statements. The JCL statement will actually have the COBOL program that can be executed. Talking about the databases, the main key databases we cover in our training programs are IMS and DB2. The database portion of IMS is called IMSDB, and the online transactional portion we call IMSDC. IMSDB DB for IMS database and DC for data communications. IMSDB is like a hierarchical database. Say take an example of a tree and then just invert the tree. So you will have the root at the top and then you will have branches. Similarly, this IMSDB, the hierarchical database, it will have a root segment under which we will have multiple child segment relationship. The segments will actually have fields and the data stored on it. So the COBOL programs can access these IMS databases for inserting, replacing or deleting the segments. Similarly, DB2 is totally different than the IMS database, which is called relational database, and it can have parent and child relationship. DB2 programs can be written in DB2 SQL statements can be embedded in COBOL programs, and the DB2 SQL statements like insert, update, delete can be written in the programs and can be accessed to and from DB2 tables. The online transaction system, which is for which the IMS system is being highly used, and the online transaction systems that we cover in our training program are CACS and IMSDC. The file access method that we cover in our training program is VXAM, Virtual Storage Access Method. So that's a brief introduction about mainframe. We will have more details of what is a batch job, what is a segment, and all the terms that we talked in our introduction section in the next videos. Thank you.